Okay, welcome back, folks. This is game, gosh, Michael, I've lost track. Is this 16, I think, or 17?
Game 17.
Oh my goodness, we are just cooking along here. Game 17, AlphaGo versus the world. And who's our victim today?
Lian Xiao gets a second chance. So it was same human player as game number 16. Lian Xiao from China. And very strong Chinese player. So he's one of the most prominent Chinese players. And he gets a second chance to play against AlphaGo. Actually, he played 3 games in all in this series.
Okay.
So Lian Xiao has the Black Stones again. And he's trying something a bit unusual here. Like he's, I think he just wanted to try something very unusual and see what the what master would do with it, because they probably figured out that they're playing against a computer program by now.
Right.
So it's very unusual, the 5-3 point here, as well as the fact that Black is spending 2 stones on a corner. It's not as if it doesn't work. Like, we've had openings like this in the past, hundreds of years ago, when playing 3-4 points was more popular. This was something that Black could do sometimes. And the remaining 2 corners are, they're like their mi'ai.
Right.
So Black gets one of them. But this is where we get the first eye-opener of this game, because AlphaGo is white. It's going to break a rule here. Like, we used to say that kicking here was just bad because it would give Black a 3-space extension, right? You're allowing your opponent to play a 3-space extension from a pillar of 2 stones. It's supposed to be bad. Because if White had played here and Black had played that, there would have still been the opportunity to invade here.
Sure.
So it goes against the rules, sort of, to play this kicking move. But this was so obviously effective that immediately after this game, people started to imitate this. And so the way it's effective is the fact that if Black does do that, if Black does play some kind of 3-space extension on the side, then pressing here becomes such a perfect move for White. This would just be, actually, this just looks bad for Black already. And the fact that Black has such a low position, at least Black would play maybe high on the fourth line. But even then, pressing here would be an option for White. And Black would be forced to a relatively low position. And so while the theory we had is saying that Black, White should not do this because it allows Black to play that three-space extension. When we come to this position, it suddenly becomes apparent that Black doesn't really want to do that. Black doesn't want to play that three-space extension that was supposed to be so perfect for Black. And so Black played here. But now White gets to pincer. And so kicking here in the corner was supposed to be a good move only when White has this pincer. So suddenly it's become a good move here.
Am I totally off? But I mean, I'd love to know what Leela has to say about the percentages at this point. It feels terrible, but maybe I'm wrong.
It's pretty close to even, actually.
Okay.
But it is a difficult position for Black to be playing in.
Yeah.
And I'm going to suggest that Black should have played a 2-space extension here, which is similar in that it's stopping White from pressing. It's reducing the value of this move because there's no follow-up now.
Right.
So it's reducing the value of that move. And it's also reducing the value of a White invasion here because there's no space for White to make a base on the left side now. So White's not going to jump in there in this case. So it's a bit slightly submissive because it's on the third line, but it also gets rid of all of White's potential on the left side of the board. So White's probably not going to be immediately doing anything there. White might be playing something to the something on the lower side area, like this, for instance. So it would solve Black's problem. So this was the suggested move by Leela, actually. But at the time, it was sort of normal to play the Kosumi here, and White plays the pincer. So this is... Suddenly, White's kick there, the marked move, is looking like a very reasonable move. Black naturally extends. This actually could have been an extension here. It's a very subtle difference. I think this is still okay. and white plays here. And this is where it turns out black had a more effective move. Black sort of peeped here. In the game, black plays the attachment on the outside. And the fact that black does not have a very satisfying shape to connect up to this stone is making it a bit of a problem move. So black should have played here just to probe and see how white answers. So if white answers on this side, black gets to peep on the second line. And this is threatening the cut here, pushing through and cutting on the second line, which would be very drastic. And also, of course, the connection on the second line. And there is one way for white to stop both of those. So white will probably play here. But in this case, black has a much better shape moving out into the center. And this would actually be okay for black. This would be an even fight. It's not as if AlphaGo has done anything wrong. So it's about 50-50. But this would be the best variation for black. Otherwise, when black peeps here, if white connects on the from the corner, in this case, black is going to go ahead and push through. And after cutting once here, black can still escape on the side. And so it's a much more sharp variation. But the fact that black has got a cut in here, it's more the cut here on that is forcing white to eventually, it'll force white to play a stone to capture it. It'll give black an extra move for the fight on the left side. And so having that cut at five, where I can mark the stone, having that cut here is much more effective for black than having that one attachment that black had in the game. The attachment here, when white just extends here, black doesn't really want to pull back. It's sort of a clunky move to pull back and have white play here. Black doesn't have very much impetus out into the center. So black played the capping move here.
Oh, yeah, that's nice.
And played here. And the idea here is that if white answers, then black can play on the top here. Turns out it might have been better for black to just play here after all.
Sure.
But this is not already, it's not the best variation for black. Like, it's probably slightly less than 50%. But it is close enough to an even fight. This would have been better. The fact that black played one move here, there's no chance that white's going to answer here. White immediately starts attacking in the center. And you see that black group. This black group is going to be a problem for black throughout the game. It's just going to be trouble for black. So white switches to the lower left area here. Instead of just jumping out like this, it's more effective to be playing this move and sort of probing to see how black answers it. And every move, it's the problem with AlphaGo is it's so perfect. It doesn't make mistakes. It's the perfect timing here for white to ask black how black is going to respond, because black has a choice between this move, taking away white's base in the corner, and this move. This might have been better, actually. But at this point, white can live in on the side or in the corner. I would expect something like this to happen, in which case white is alive in the corner. And this might have been better than the game for black. It's still a difficult fight. This way, black 11 is a double purpose move. It gets rid of the cut here at the same time as threatening white's connection at this point. So it is a kind of a double purpose move, a nice move to be able to play. This might have been a little better than the game. In the game, after black plays here and captures in the corner, this gives some extra odds for white to be looking at the attachment here to cut black off. And when white jumps out here, the game is now looking more better for white. It's closer to 60% for white. And so white probably has about 3 points lead, 2 or 3 points lead, if, according to our AI friends. I wouldn't be calculating that at this point. It's still a very subtle difference. And I just want to go through to show you one final mistake that black made. At this point, black's playing quite reasonably. Black captured here, and this followed. Capturing was maybe not the best move. It might have been slightly better to pull back here. In either case, black has to do something about this cut here, because white can cut here to capture the black stone. And that was made possible by the fact that white added a stone to white's group here. So white can capture the black stones like this. So black did need to add something. The question is whether this is better. This is taking away white's eyes on the side, but this might have been better, taking one step towards cutting white off in the center of the board.
Mm-hmm.
So looking forward to be playing a move like this or like this next. So in the game black took this way, white could fix the connection. Usually you would expect white to continue with a move like this, but mm-hmm. when it's AlphaGo, white is not going to spend a move there. White's going to find something more efficient. It's very typical of AlphaGo to play like this and connect underneath. And I'm going to call this the losing move, actually.
Oh, wow.
It's a move that I would play without thinking. Like, this is so obvious that this is looks like an important point that I would not think about playing this move. It's a good point for white to play, too. Like, black's move should be on the upper side. This was the last big point. And so it's another pattern that I see a lot in AlphaGo's games where the human player plays this important point, which is supposed to set up an attack, and AlphaGo just plays on the other side of the board. It plays the last big point. Because this point is a good point for white to play also. But if you look at it closely, you see that this area, it's sort of nullified by the fact that black has this strong group on the right side. And so it's not all that much space. So if we look at the whole board position, after all, the upper side is the final big point. And black had to take that. So if black had played here, it would have still been close to something like 60%, 60-40, a slight advantage for white. But like with correct play, it would just be 2 or 3 points difference. It would be nothing. Human game, it would be very easy to have that change in favor of black. So, but once this happens, white just takes control. And this is a position where I can see that white has an advantage already. With white takes control of the upper side. And the fact that black's group here, this group is still going to play black from throughout the rest of the game. I think I remember I did a commentary on this game. Shortly after. There's probably a video somewhere on the net, probably an AGA site, about my talking about this game. We're going to see white attacking this group, but not even trying to kill it. And it's going to last throughout, that attack is going to sort of last throughout the game until suddenly it's just an end game. There's nowhere left to play. So it's going to be, this group, it's going to play black much more than black can hope to attack white, the white group on the outside. The white group is actually surprisingly strong, this white group. And of course, white's group on the lower side is just completely alive here on with territory on the side.
Sure.
And so after this, AlphaGo just takes the game away.
Yeah. And it's a good lesson for amateurs as well, because when you look at the game, you know, white does sort of torture the group and chase it, but as you say, doesn't bother to kill it because it doesn't need to kill it. It makes its profit in the attack, which of course we've all been told.
Well, to be honest, it couldn't kill it, but maybe it would have if it could. But there, if with a human player like myself, there would be the tendency to want to try to kill it,
exactly.
And that would lead to mistakes.
It gets you in trouble, exactly. Thank you for that translation. What I was trying to say.
Yeah.
All right, great. Thank you very much. Hope you guys enjoyed this game, and keep tuned for our next one. All right, take care.